السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الحمد لله, one third of Ramadan has passed and there's two thirds left. One of the things that is very important about Ramadan is that we increase in ibadah, increase in worship, increase in becoming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our role model, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was a leader in ibadah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the messengers and the prophets, وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ فِعْلَ الْخَيْرَاتِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ وَكَانُوا لَنَا عَابِدِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we made the messengers a'imma, leaders. They were guided and they guided others, and we inspired them to perform all types of good deeds and establishing the salah and the zakat. وَكَانُوا لَنَا عَابِدِينَ. They were to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pure, true worshippers. Aisha radiallahu anha, she narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will pray during the night prayers to the point where his feet will start to hurt. And Aisha would say, Ya Rasulullah, you are the messenger of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave your past sins and your future sins. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam responded, should I not be then a grateful servant? This was in a normal day. How about in Ramadan? We will talk about, inshallah, an average day of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam during Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will wake up at night and he will do suhoor, which is barakah, and he will do it with either one of his wives or with the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. And he will have just a few dates, or he will have a light suhoor. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will pray during the night. Around 50 verses of the Quran will be recited during his night prayers. And then he will wait until Adhan al-Fajr will come and pray two rak'ah and then pray Fajr with the Jama'ah. After Salat al-Fajr, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will sit down and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that whoever does this until the sun would rise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write for him and accepted Hajj and Umrah, subhanallah. Then he will go home and spend time with his family and help his family. Just before Maghrib Salah, he will do his Adhkar al-Masa'. And then he will make lots of adiyah, lots of dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The adhan of Maghrib will come and he will break it with a light meal, such as a few dates or rutab, which is similar to dates. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will pray Maghrib with the jama'ah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will pray after Salat al-Isha, the night prayers. And this was done for the first 3 days of Ramadan. Then he performed it at home. No doubt, like Umar radiallahu anhu said, that praying the Taraweeh prayers is not an obligation on us, but the fasting is. However, we should still perform it if we want to become noble, righteous people. Let us, inshallah ta'ala, follow our Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our role model. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Indeed, with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a perfect role model. He is a role model in ibadah, in his relationship with his family, his wives, his children, with the neighbors, with the guests. But in particular, this blessed month of Ramadan, let us, inshallah ta'ala, follow his footsteps and increase in our ibadah so that we may become from the muttaqeen and we may become from those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our fast and become from the people of paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you your salah and your siyam and all of your good deeds. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.